with high ambitions. Let the world see what you have got. Bring it all back to you. Dream of falling in love. Anything you've been thinking of. When the world seems to get too tough, bring it all back to you.
Sleeps in running shoes.
Morning.
Helen, you've missed the shuttle race. Rachel's beaten us in again.
Oh well.
Oh well, what's so well? We dedicate our whole lives to getting into the shuttle before Rachel. What is wrong with you?
I got up early, so I went in.
You had a shower and then you went back to bed?
No, I didn't go in the shower actually. I thought it'd be more polite to wait.
Wait? Wait for what?
For the cockroach to finish using it.
Cockroach!
I guess he's still in there.
After you, Paul.
No, I insist. After you.
Go on, Bradley, in you go, mate.
No, I don't even need the loo, I thought.
There's a cockroach in our bathroom. It's huge. It's like the Luciano Pavarotti of cockroaches.
What, it sings in the shower?
Well, if it does it very quietly.
And let me guess, you're all frightened to go in there.
Yeah, all right, so we're scared of a little tiny cockroach. Go on, have a good laugh. Go on.
Okay.
Enough. So anyway, we're frightened to use the shower.
Can we use yours?
No.
Don't open that door.
Why, has Brad been eating curried beans again?
No, it's not Brad, it's a...
It's an orthoptera. That's right, it's a Blatidae orientalis.
Is it? I thought it was just a cockroach.
Bradley, that is a cockroach in Latin.
Yeah, but it's not even an American cockroach.
I can't believe you were making fun out of us when even you were too scared to go in the loo because of your cockroach.
Yeah, but our cockroach is bigger than your cockroach.
Can we focus, please? We're telling Howard that we're not happy sharing our accommodation with that thing.
I feel sorry for the poor little creature. I'm glad I didn't tell you about the one in the kitchen.
The kitchen?
Oh my God, there was one in the kitchen.
And you didn't tell us?
I didn't tell anyone. Well, apart from one customer.
You told the customer? Hannah, what happens if you tell someone else? What happens if the authorities get to hear about this?
What authorities?
Okay, team, move in. Kitchen first!
Those authorities?
Excuse me, what's happening?
Nothing to worry about, young lady. Just a spot check.
Spot check? They take their skincare so seriously in America, don't they?
Okay, Mr. Borlotti. You have one major infestation here.
Well, thank you very much. We do our very best. Don't I know you? Don't I know him, Marvin?
His face is familiar. Oh, wait a minute. That's Inspector Crow from the Department of Labor. Yeah, he sent us down for breaking the employment regulations. How you doing?
That's correct. And what goes down must also come up. I am now Chief Inspector Crow of the Department of Health. And you, sir, are overrun with insects, vermin, bacteria, viruses, one more species, and I could declare this place a game reserve.
Would I be able to put that in the brochure?
You are slightly missing my point. I'm closing you down.
You think you could close us down? Do you think you could come in here and just wave a microscope around and close Howie's hotel down? Do you? Because if you do, I have one simple question for you.
What's that?
Are you open at all to bribery?
No.
Then I'm in deep doo-doo.
And you know how you can get yourself out of that deep doo-doo?
Toilet train the rats?
Eliminate the rats, the bugs, the germs, and until you do, I'm closing the place down.
But the staff rely on me. They're like family. You know, really irritating, never do as they're told. If you close us down, they'll still expect to be paid. Oh.
I'll be back in 4 days, and if this place isn't clean, I'm closing you down for good.
You never liked us. Marvin, do something.
Want a Tic Tac?
Howard, what's happening?
The Department of Health has ruled this hotel unsanitary.
And I have to close down for 4 days to get this place deloused.
Woo!
Yeah, 4 days off.
A vacation.
A fully compensated vacation.
Well, I would like to pay you, vocabulary kid. I would like to pay the whole staff, but sadly, I can't. doctor's orders. Because if I were to do something like that, it would kill me. And you don't want my death on your conscience, do you?
We'll have to get back to you on that.
So, I'm sending everyone off on the annual staff retreat.
The what?
The what? What annual staff retreat?
The annual staff retreat. You see, every year I send everybody away for a few days rest and relaxation at a top resort. Why, it's a tradition.
Since when?
I don't remember any annual retreat.
See, it goes back even longer than he can remember. It does. And this year, it happens at Sequarium Dolphin Cove.
A dolphin cove? You mean we'll be swimming with dolphins?
Short kid. There'll probably be so many people staying there, you'll have to share your room with the dolphin. Marvin!
S Club!
Hey guys, we're off to swim with the dolphins. You coming?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, we're right behind you.
Yeah, you just try and stop us.
Tina, Hannah.
Hi, I'm Janine. I understand you're interested in the dolphins.
That's us.
You want to come with me?
Yep, I'm interested in dolphins too. In fact, I love all marine animals. I've seen Jaws 6 times. I feel that shark was deeply misunderstood. Hey Bradley, look, there are girls here.
Yeah, I know. But the trick with girls is to treat them like buses. Yeah, if you miss one, another one will be along in a minute.
Oh, for a second there, I thought you meant don't put your feet on their seats.
And don't be too keen, because I'd never run after a girl.
Yeah, that's what Rachel says about blokes.
Yeah, but Rachel's just... Where is Rachel? And Joe?
They're down the other end of the beach watching the photo shoot. You know, the one with all the models. Bradley?
Okay, this is Donnie. He's a...
Sagittarius?
No, Leo, actually. He's been with us for about 6 years. Did you know that in many ways dolphins are more intelligent than humans?
I find that very hard to believe.
Do you?
Yeah, well, after all, man is the ruler of the entire planet.
Dolphins are highly social and extremely intelligent. In fact, some people say they're almost...
Telepathic?
Yes. Do you know about dolphins?
No, Donnie just told me.
Donnie, the dolphin's talking to you.
Yeah.
She doesn't mind who chats her up.
He just said, enough with the marine lecture. When are we going to swim?
Well, we'll swim when my colleague gets here. And here he is now. This is Chip.
Hi, Chip.
Hi.
Hi. So, what's the difference between a dolphin and a porpoise?
Well, dolphins are cetaceous mammals. They come from the Plantinistidae, Delphinidae, and Grampidae families, whereas a porpoise comes from the Phenacidae family.
Fascinating. So what's the difference between a dolphin and a porpoise?
You're not really interested in that.
Aren't I?
No. You're just pretending to be interested in dolphins as part of your courtship ritual.
I am?
Yeah, it's classic courtship behavior.
It is?
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Your pupils are dilated. You have shallow breathing. You're making quick, uncoordinated movements.
No, I'm not!
Yes, you are. And you're beginning to perspire. I'm majoring in marine biology and behavioral psychology. You interest me.
Why?
How about I tell you tonight? You come pick me up at 9?
She wants me.
What's that thing for then?
It's a fire detector. He's just making sure she's not overweight. That device is the reason why all models are all constantly on a diet.
Right. Oh, right.
Joe, it's a light meter.
Yeah, I knew that.
Woo! What a love puff! What a cuticle! She's thick!
Yeah, she's okay, but I mean, I could do that. So could Joe.
You?
Rachel, modelling's not just about standing there and looking pretty, you know. Well, yes, it is, but...
You couldn't model. You're just too... Rachel.
Oh, thanks for the career advice, Bradley. I know where to go next time I want my ego boosting.
Trust me, you would never snowball in a sauna.
Excuse me, have you ever considered modelling?
Nah, I love the increase in income, but I couldn't take the job in IQ.
I was talking to your friend.
Who, me? No. I mean, yes. I mean...
You've got a great look. You could be big. If you're interested, I'd like to take some test shots of you tomorrow. Tomorrow evening, good for you?
Good? No. I mean, yes.
Great.
incredible.
It's a twilight zone. I mean, you a model.
Yeah, what was that, Brad, about me not looking like a model?
I want a second opinion from his guide dog.
Well, there's girls out there. Trying to get his attention is going to be like trying to get Rachel out the bathroom.
You mean we're going to have to set off the fire alarm?
Well, that only happened once and I was tweezing.
Come on, let's wrap it up. I've got a date tonight at 9 o'clock. In case anyone didn't hear that, me, Paul, I've got a date tonight at 9.
Yeah, all right, I'll ring those night.
Where to go, Paul? The love machine.
Sorry. Oh, no, just met this girl.
Yeah, right? All right, Brad. We could do it about a town hockey match report.
I can't. I want details.
Oh, yeah, she was a great kissy. I mean, I haven't felt this much passion since last night.
Well, you're not the only one with a love life, you know.
Yeah, Paul's got a date tonight too.
Yeah, cool. Word of advice, David.
Yeah, women are like public transport.
What?
Oh, I'll tell you later. Don't worry.
You're eating. It looks like something you'd find at the bottom of a hamster cage.
It's muesli. If I'm going to start doing modelling, I have to start eating sensibly.
Tell us when you start.
Well,
what?
Last night, what happened?
There was action.
Snogulous variety?
Yeah.
Well, we need details. How many times and for how long?
Well, she liked the way I took command. I said, Janine, baby, I'm going to kiss you. Because you know what women like, don't you? Women like...
walking up behind you?
No.
Sneaking up on people while they're not looking?
No. Women like a man...
getting right within earshot?
No. Women like a man who's not afraid to assert themselves, to take control, to...
Hi.
Hi.
Remember you said you'd help me take dolphin urine samples today?
Yeah, sure. I'm really looking forward to it.
Yeah, he's just crazy about dolphin wee.
These are my friends. This is, her and him. And, what's your name again?
Grisabella.
Grisabella. It was so embarrassing. I wanted to be like Leonardo in Titanic.
You were.
Yeah, completely out of your depth.
I really like her, guys.
Yeah, but not as much as Jennifer Aniston. As much as Zayna Warrior Princess. Natalie Imbruglia. Wow.
Wow!
I think she may be the one.
But you don't know anything about her. She might not be good enough for you, man.
Bradley's been possessed by my mum.
Listen, right. She looks like the type of girl that bites her nails and her toenails, and she's wearing far too much makeup.
She wasn't wearing any makeup.
See? She couldn't even bother to put any makeup on. Dump her.
Bradley, there's so many women out there. Can't you even bear just to leave one for me?
I was well out of order, Bradley McIntosh.
Yeah, anyone would think you fancied her.
Well, I might. Spent most of last night snugging her.
I don't know about dolphin-friendly tuna. I mean, it's all right for you guys, but it's still not so great for the tuna. That's a very fishiest remark.
Hannah, what are we going to do about Paul and Janine?
It's none of our business.
But she snogged Bradley after she promised to go out on a date with Paul. You know what that makes her, don't you?
Absent-minded?
No, a two-timer, and we can't let Paul go out with someone like that.
It's none of our business who Paul goes out with. If anyone should tell Janine, it's Bradley.
Maybe you're right. Where is Bradley?
Donny says he's gone to help Joe turn Rachel into a supermodel.
Oh, right. And Donny the dolphin just knows things like that, does he?
No, silly. How can he know things like that? The halibut just told him.
I still can't decide. Joe, try some of this raspberry Mardi Gras on to see how it looks.
No, I'm still wearing autumn blush over Sienna Fanfare. I'm not careful, my lips are going to start clashing.
Oh, this is so stressful. No wonder Kate Moss always looks so grumpy. All I'm asking for is a little help with how I should look at the photo shoot. I mean, I'd go for the natural look, but I've only got 2 hours.
It's like we're near enough time.
Bradley, what do you think?
I think I wish I stayed at the beach. I mean, is it medically possible to die of embarrassment?
Have you seen Janine?
Oh, maybe you should take things a bit slower, Janine. I mean, you're getting serious about her, and she might possibly not be quite as serious.
I think I know her a bit better than you. After all, she's my girlfriend.
Your what?
What's wrong with that?
Paul, she's been seen snogging other blokes, and she wasn't giving mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
You've seen her with other blokes?
Not exactly. I mean, I haven't.
Well, then who did?
I can't tell you.
Of course you can't, because you just made it up, because you're jealous and you can't stand to see me happy.
Donny just said you made a hash of that.
Tell Donny to go play by the tuna boats.
Well, here I am. How do I look?
And more to the point, why?
You look great. Could you take off those gloves?
Oh, sure.
Great. Now, can you come stand over here in front of this reflector?
Sure.
Thank you. Now hold this.
Oh, okay.
Oh, fantastic. Intense. Oh, yes. Can you extend your forefinger a little bit? Oh, yes.
Oh, hello.
Yes.
Excuse me. I'm up here.
Is there a problem?
Look, I know I'm just a beginner, but why are you photographing the wrench?
For your test shots. Wrenches Are Us needs a new hand model.
Wrenches Are Us? A hand model? But aren't you going to photograph the rest of me?
Why would I want to do that?
But I thought that...
I mean, hey, babe, let's get real here. Your hands are so much better than the rest of you. And they're fantastic hands. I just can't get enough of your hands.
Really? You like my hands?
Yes. Hey, what was that for?
Oh, I was just giving you a closer look.
Ow, 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 ow. Hey, what the hell was that?
That was Rachel telling you that after reviewing her options...
She decided against a career in modeling.
People's mistakes will only cause you to make big ones of your own.
Do you really think so?
Oh, yeah. Okay, Mum.
Excuse me.
Hi.
Hi.
Titus voice.
What are you trying to do? Get into the Guinness Book of Records?
I beg your pardon?
Why agree to go out with Paul if you're going to road test the lips of the entire male population of southern Florida?
Paul? Hold on. Ah, Paul Cattermole? English, non-territorial, passive-aggressive tendencies tempered by the constant need for peer approval. He's got a nice haircut.
What?
My research notes.
And does Paul know you've been studying quite so hard in the evening?
No, because if I told him, it would affect his behavior and it'd make my notes invalid.
So do you even like Paul?
Of course I like Paul. I like him just like I like all my experiments.
Listen, just let Paul down gently, you manipulative, slimy, four-timing, nasty, scraggy...
psychologist.
Then she says she's not going to finish with him, and I can't make her.
What a broomstick jockey.
Yeah, relationships are like Porsches. They're easy to get into, but really hard to get out of without losing your dignity.
So, girls are like buses, and relationships are like Porsches.
Hmm.
I think I'm just going to give up on girls and concentrate on passing my driving test.
The worst thing is, she's right. There's nothing we can do without alienating Paul.
Donnie says there is something we can do.
Can you stop talking about that stupid dolphin?
Where is Paul anyway?
He's swimming with that stupid dolphin. He wants to surprise Janine.
I tell you what, I think he will.
Okay, Paul, doing good. Just let Donnie pull you along and... Donnie, what are you doing? Where are you going? Stop! Stop!
Oh, hi. This is Carl. He's helping me with my thesis.
I bet he is. Oral exam, is it?
Hey, pal, this is a private party. Why don't you just butt out?
Butt out? I want to kick your butt all the way to Poughkeepsie.
Yeah, I bet you know where Poughkeepsie is.
Well, actually, I don't, but I know an awful lot of things get kicked there.
But I'm not going to tell you twice.
I'm warning you. I'm British, and I'm a master of the British martial art of playing the spoons.
Oh, yeah, well, I'm really scared, right?
That was impressive.
Not really. I lied about playing the spoons. Janine, I...
I'm impressed too.
Shut up, Carl.
S Club.
Hey, sorry about what happened with Janine, man. Are you alright?
Yeah. As long as you're not about to tell me that girls are like heavy goods vehicles, then I'll be fine. Besides, Janine may have been bad news for me, but she's definitely helped out Tina.
How do you mean?
Well, Chip felt so responsible that Janine and I broke up during his swimming lesson that Tina just had to go and comfort him.
Yeah, he looks pretty comforted.
And Hannah asked Donnie for some advice on my love life.
Yeah, what did he say?
Oh, but there's plenty more fish in the sea.
And let's face it, he should know.